Hello learners, welcome to NIOS. Today we will study lesson number 9. The title of the lesson is Introduction to Health. We will study this lesson in 3 parts. So let us begin with the first part of the lesson number 9. Dear learners, before we start, let us know about the objectives of the present lesson. We will study the meaning as well as concept of health. We will classify and explain various dimensions of health. We will also learn about the principles of health. Further, we will explain which factors could affect our health. At last, we will also know what is the yogic concept of health as well as its characteristics. So, we are going to start with meaning and concept of health. Health is universal in nature, but all sects of society have their own concept of health according to their culture. The strength of a nation lies upon the health of its people. The future of the people in respect to health relies to a large extent on what is done by the nation to promote, improve and preserve health of its people. Happiness in life largely depends upon condition of our health. In the recent times, it has been observed that health is emerged as a fundamental human right. Good health is required to satisfy our basic needs. It is a global goal to facilitate a healthy life to all people. Earlier, it was believed that health is a situation of being hale. Hale means safe and sound. Well, if you search meaning of health, you will find results such as freedom from disease, the state of being free from illness or injury, sound body and mind, or condition in which functions of our body and mind are duly discharged. In Ayurveda, health swasth defined as a well-balanced metabolism, happy state of being, the senses and mind. Swami Vivekananda also said, a weak person who has weak body or weak mind can never be a master of a strong soul. Aristotle has also stated that a sound mind lives in a sound body. Recent researches related with the health have been expanding its definition. The concept of health has been extended and now it is not merely presence or absence of disease. It included the notion of well-being, which contains biological, sociological, economical, psychological and cultural well-being. This wide-ranging concept of health has its origins in the WHO 1948 definition of health. That is, health is a state of complete physical, mental and social well-being and not merely the absence of disease or infirmity. This definition has been amplified and it has been added attainment of a level of health that will enable every individual to lead a socially and economically productive life. This seems health is difficult to define but easier to understand. The definition of health has changed by the time. Many of us define it as absence of disease or infirmity, and some of think as sound mind and sound function of the body. Health is not only the absence of illness or deformity, it is the quality of life where fitness for performing own work and happiness are at distinct marks. Thus, we can say good health means the proper functioning of the physique, which you could say physical parts of the body, the chemical reactions inside the body and the psychic, the harmonious functioning of the mind. At last, we can say health is a condition where an individual is physically, mentally, socially, emotionally and spiritually sound. Thus, it is more than just being disease-free or free from any physical deformity. Learners, you have learned the concept as well as meaning of health. Now, we are going to learn definitions of health. According to J.F. Williams, health is the quality of life that enables an individual to live most and serve best. Webster Collegiate Dictionary defines health as the state of being sound in body, mind or spirit, especially freedom from physical disease or pain. According to D. Obrettiefer, health is the condition of the organism which measures the degree to which its aggregate powers are able to function. After learning these definitions, you can say health is a quality of life where an individual is in condition of being sound in all aspects of life and able to serve the nation in a better productive way. Dear learners, so let us understand the different dimensions of health. Learners, health is a multidimensional concept because it is shaped by biological, social, economical concepts. Now, recently few more dimensions are added in this, which is educational, emotional, spiritual, as well as occupational. Physical dimension, which refers the proper and smooth functioning of external as well as internal features of our body. External features refers to the attractive appearance of body, where it is physique, texture and complexion, features, posture, body parts and limbs. It is also includes graceful carriage and efficient movement. When we talk about internal dimension, it covers, you can say it refers to the optimum functioning of all organic system of our body, that is digestive, circulatory, respiratory, nervous and excretory. Now, mental dimension of health refers to mental soundness. Often mental dimension of health is linked to emotional dimension of health, but both are different. Mental dimension of health is related with the functioning of brain, while emotional dimension refers to the individual's behavior or mood, which is more or less connected to our hormones. Mental health refers to our ability to use our brain. This ability enables us to face the problems as they arise, take our own decision, and as well as sets reasonable goals. Social dimension of health is related with social health. It refers to the ability where we are able to make personal adjustment as well as adjustment in the group or society. Sound social health means having a good relationship with family, friends, neighbors and other members of the society. It also includes maintenance of socially acceptable standard in life. When we have a sound social interaction and relationship with fellow beings, that significantly affect our health. Emotional dimension refers to emotional health, which means emotional balance. It is the ability to comprehend and express our feelings effectively when required. We can call ourselves emotionally healthy if our emotions are always positive and we have full control over our emotions. On the other hand, if we have no control over our emotions or is overpowered with negative emotions, we can be called emotionally imbalanced. Spiritual dimensions of health has a root in spirit. Our spirit contributed significantly in recognizing and attaining meaning and purpose of our life. It is our spirit which plays an important role in genesis of ideas, values, beliefs and ethics. This dimension plays a significant role because if we are spiritually healthy, then we will be able to come up with best ideas and we will have good values, beliefs as well as ethics. Occupational dimension, also known as vocational dimension, which is the ability to satisfy our personal needs from our job or business. Our progress depends upon our capacity to earn our livelihood and to meet our economic needs. If we are occupationally satisfied, that will provide us emotional stability and mental relaxation. Occupationally satisfied persons also contribute to nation in the increase of production as well as national wealth. Thus, occupational health is a great national importance as well. Educational dimension. Education is consciously controlled process whereby a positive modification in our behavior occurred and through us in the group. It causes certain positive changes in our behavior and attitude. These changes enable us to realize our responsibilities to the society and the nation. In this video, we have studied about the meaning, definition and dimensions of health. We will continue with the present topic in the second part of this lesson. I hope you will like watching this video. Thanks for watching. Namaskar.